Hey guys, this is PJ with the High Mountain Homestead, and I just wanted to shoot a quick video today because I've just had this on my mind, so I want to just pick up the camera. And while I'm doing some chores, this fence has no electrical current going through it, which is why I'm allowed to just hop over it. But just while I'm moving some sprinklers today, I just wanted to talk about something that's been on my mind for a little bit. And that's why eating organic actually matters. So I saw somebody, I don't even remember who, on my Facebook feed, just like repost something that said like, it was just ranting about a bunch of stuff, because there's a lot to rant about these days, but justified things. But they also just tagged onto it, also, organic is BS. I was like, what? And it's just stuck with me, and I can't... Anyway, so I've been thinking about it, and I wanted to articulate why that's wrong, why that's so wrong. And I think a lot of people stop the conversation at organic with just that it's more expensive, or it's harder to farm, or that it's pesticide-free. And all those things are true, but I wanted to... The sprinkler has been on all day here, and it's like I'm walking through a swamp right now. Let's see if I can hold this in one hand and hold the sprinkler in the other. But what I wanted to talk about is why organic matters for so many more reasons than just, yeah, it's a few cents more expensive, usually, especially when we're talking about produce. But organic matters for a lot of reasons. Again, this is just an impromptu video, so I don't necessarily have a fixed number of reasons, but the first reason is it matters because it's the health of an animal we're talking about. If something is farmed organically, I said animal, it could be a plant as well, but if something is farmed organically, you can sure bet, okay, look at that, it's not what you want to see. I thought I had the hose pinched off, I guess I didn't. But if something is farmed or raised organically, you can usually bet that that plant or animal has lived a healthy life. So if you know much about animal meat, this is a great example. So most animals are eaten when they're younger rather than older. I know it's sad. I know I personally used to think while I was growing up that, oh yeah, cow lives a full life, and when they're about to croak over, you eat them. That's not the case. The meat just doesn't taste the same. And I think that there's also something to blame in the industry, because the industry would prefer to eat animals while they're young for another reason besides taste. And that's that animals don't live as long if they're kept in terrible living conditions. And so if you're eating organic, you're eating animals that were likely living in situations good enough that they did not have to have antibiotics given to them regularly just to survive. You know, you see those videos that are really sad of chickens that live basically on their own poop for their whole life. And yeah, you're gonna need antibiotics to live through that, because animals shouldn't be living through that. Same thing with cows. If you're ever on the freeway and you see one of those, you know, big dairy or meat cow operations, and it smells, and you got to turn off your air or switch it to the circulated air or roll up the windows or whatever, like, that's because animals aren't supposed to live that way. And organic really, really matters because it's a healthier animal. Animals. Like, we usually eat, you know, one-year-old sheep, two-year-old cows, and, like, they couldn't live past that age. Like, it's been proven that cows that eat majority of corn their whole life, which they're not supposed to eat, they can't live to adulthood. They develop diseases, so we eat them while they're younger. Corn-fed beef is a different topic, one that I'm also passionate about, but today I'm talking about organic. And eating organic is important because it justifies a healthier animal. That's what you're putting in your body. You should want that animal to have lived a healthy life as well. Okay, another thing about organic is that it's harder work for the farmer. Here's some of my lambs. It's just fun to look at them. It's harder work for the farmer because organic is, you know, it's like you're playing a video game without any cheat codes. And you're playing it on the hardest mode because if you're gardening, for example, I actually have some chores to do in the garden, so why don't I walk that way? If you're gardening, for example, and you've got a pesticide out there, you don't have as many weeds to pull. And pulling weeds sucks. Like, I pull multiple handfuls of weeds a day, and I only have 4 boxes out right now. My goal is to have double or triple that by the end of the season. We're building them slowly. Side note, the weeds are really nice because the chickens will eat them, which is always fun. That's a big pile of wet poop because it's been on a sprinkler all day. Another thing on weeds are job security for farmers, especially for organic farmers. It's harder, but if it's harder, then hopefully that farmer is getting more compensated when you're buying organic. Because what you're paying for in organic food isn't necessarily the fact that it costs more inherently to farm organically. It takes more effort, for sure. Okay, so I've got a lot of friends that are interested in this lifestyle but aren't necessarily interested enough to pursue it. And we have a lot of good conversation about it. But I really think that those folks that are interested in homesteading should really consider buying organic food regularly. Now, I know a lot of people buy organic strictly because they don't want pesticides on their vegetables. And hey, if that's reason enough, that's awesome. But it's a lot more than that. I remember, like, before we started this whole operation here, we were buying organic leafy greens and fruits and stuff like that. So, for example, like everything here, we got spinach, cabbage, a lot of greens and stuff like that. But like these beets, for example, we probably weren't buying organic beets to start out with, because my thought going into organic farming was all I care about is the pesticides. I just don't want pesticides on my food. And the beet has the leaf that's above ground, so the actual beet fruit or beet root, I guess is what it is, wouldn't have the pesticides on it. But it's just irresponsible to think that only where the pesticide touches is the only place where you're getting a negative impact from the pesticide. Okay, so I've talked about how organic is healthier for the animal, it's healthier for the plant. And on the High Mountain Homestead, we're all about better plants, better animals, but also better soil. And so I just want to go back to that and talk about pesticides are just not good for the soil. Like, if you look at the pesticide industry, what happened was after World War II and the war was won and troops were coming home, but we still had factories that were making munitions. My sheep's very passionate about munitions factories. But you had these factories that were making, you know, ammunition and explosives and things like that. And we had all the infrastructure for that, but we weren't at war anymore. So what did they do? They started making fertilizers. And we over-fertilized our land with these chemicals, just these nasty chemicals. And then to compensate for that, we had to create these nasty pesticides. And it's just been this rolling, and then now we have this huge, disgusting monocrop system in the U.S. where corn and soy are growing at, we're just growing a product that's not healthy for humans and it's not healthy for animals, and we feed it to both humans and animals these days. And buying organic is a step in the direction to say, hey, I'm actually not okay with that. I'm actually not okay with the fact that people, with big agriculture, you know, deciding what's good for the soil that is part of my country and my land. And so organic is so much more than just the fact that whether it has pesticides on it or not. To me and my family, it's a stance that we take on whether or not we want to support big agriculture. And I think organic is a way for us to, you know, do, I mean, we produce a lot of our own food here, but what we have to buy at the store, we prefer to buy organic, not just because it's better for us or for the plant, but I believe it's a better situation for the farmer in the future. Hey, thanks for watching. Sorry this was a little impromptu, but I hope it changed someone's mind out there. I really think that organic is beneficial. I do realize there's a cost associated with it, so start small if you can. But organic matters. It doesn't just matter for you, for the animal. It matters for the future and for the farmer. If you enjoyed the video, we're the High Mountain Homestead. I hope you subscribe. I hope you like the video. We're posting stuff like this at least once a week. So I'll see you again on the channel. Until next time, PJ with the High Mountain Homestead. See ya!